Hey, hey, want some slice of pizza?
No, thanks. I'm gluten-free. Okay, so you've all probably noticed how much gluten-free there is around these days. Gluten-free bread, gluten-free pasta, gluten-free stamped on friggin' everything. But is gluten something that we really need to be avoiding? Well, back in the 1990s, scientists uncovered the genetic markers for a disease called celiac disease. Celiac disease is a serious autoimmune disorder, meaning that the immune system of the body is so overpowerful that it begins to attack itself. So in the case of celiac disease, the immune system will begin to attack the body's small intestines, which can cause horrible symptoms like stabbing pain and bloody diarrhea and an inability to absorb essential nutrients and therefore death. The only known treatment for celiac disease is to avoid things that cause the sensitivity, gluten. Now, at roughly the same time as we were beginning to understand this thing called celiac disease, Dr. Robert Atkins came out with his book, The New Diet Revolution, leading to the famous term, the Atkins diet. Now, as you may know, the Atkins diet is very strict in avoiding carbohydrates. And since carbohydrates and gluten are found in most of the same food groups, pasta, bread, wheat grains, those carb-hating folks on the Atkins diet saw avoiding gluten as a more socially acceptable way of saying,
hey Jayde, you want some pizza?
No thanks. I'm on the low-carb Atkins diet, you know, because I'm fat and I want to look better. I mean, it makes sense, right? Carbs are bad. They're found in the same foods as gluten. Gluten causes some people to get very sick. So the whole gluten avoiding thing got caught up in this low carb fad, and then it became this like general health movement. And so it quickly became ixnay on the utenglay. And so now about 30% of adults say that they are actively trying to avoid eating gluten, most of whom don't even know why they're trying to avoid it. They just have this vague notion that gluten is, quote, bad for you. And ironically, gluten is not even a carb. It's a type of protein. And that's the tricky thing about being human. Our intelligence helps us to recognize patterns everywhere, even if none exist. So if we see a whole bunch of people avoiding gluten and we see a whole bunch of people avoiding carbs, we avoid them both even though we're not sure why. And a lot of the time, we're just avoiding them as a type of insurance policy. And yes, there is also something called gluten sensitivity, which is separate from celiac disease. Yet strangely, the research is mixed on whether gluten is what actually causes the symptoms of gluten sensitivity, which is actually a huge controversy in science in and of itself, and we're not gonna go there. Back to gluten. For most people, avoiding gluten has no health benefits and can actually be harmful to our bodies and to the hip pocket. First of all, the grains that the gluten-free dieter tries to avoid are essential to our health. Many grains are rich in fiber, which is great for your metabolism, and therefore actually helps you stay healthy and in shape. Grains also have a ton of important vitamins and minerals like B12, zinc, and iron. And then there's the fact that these gluten-free products can range from 50% to 200% more expensive than their regular counterparts. That can add up to thousands of dollars of excess spending in a year, for no reason. So before you take on any kind of diet, you should always consult your doctor. The only way to know if you really have celiac disease or gluten sensitivity is to get tested by a physician. And if they tell you that you're clear on gluten, go eat some spaghetti.
Hi everyone, I'm Jayde Lovell, resident science nerd on the Young Turks Network. You're watching ScIQ, and we know you don't want to miss an episode, so please click the subscribe button down below.